In our earlier class, we have seen proofs, theorems and their proofs. Now in this class, we will see examples based on those theorems. So I welcome you all in this class. See the example. This is your example 4. Show that integration from 1 to 2 f dx is equal to 11 by 2, where the function f is given as 3x plus 1. With your integration rules, you can very easily integrate this function and get the result. But here you need to apply Riemann integration techniques to get the integration of this function 3x plus 1. See, suppose we have a P is equal to a partition of the interval 1, 2 as x0, x1, x2, so on, xn, where this x0 is 1 and xn is 2. This is a partition and it divides the interval 1 to 2, 1, 2 into n equal sub intervals. So the length of each interval will be 2 minus 1 by n, means it is 1 by n because it is b minus a by n. So that mu p means norm of the partition p. This is equal to 1 by n, since it is constant, so it will be 1 by n. And it tends to 0 as n tends to infinity. So see, we need to have this one, that mu p tends to 0. It means 1 by n tends to 0 as n tends to infinity. Now your xi, x0 is 1, so x1 is 1 plus 1 by n, x2 is 1 plus 2 by n, and similarly xi is 1 plus I by n for I is equal to 1 to 1 n. And delta xi means length of each sub interval, it is your 1 by n for I equal to 1 to 1 n. Then summation delta i is varying from 1 to n will be n into 1 by n, so it is equal to 1. Now let Ti be equal to Xi when I is equal to 1 to so on n, then evaluate SPF. What will be this SPF? This is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to n FTi delta Xi. This is the definition. So this is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to n FTi means FXi delta Xi, because we have taken Ti is equal to Xi. So it is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to n 3Xi plus 1 delta Xi. Why? Because Fx is 3x plus 1. So fxi will be 3xi plus 1. It means it is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to n 3 into xi. This xi is our 1 plus y by n. So it is 3 into 1 plus I by n plus 1 into delta xi. 3 into 1 means 3 plus 1 means 4. So it is equal to 4 into summation I is equal to 1 to n delta xi plus 3 by n square summation I is equal to 1 to n I. Because this delta xi is 1 upon n. So this is equal to 4. This summation delta xi I is equal to 1 to n will be 2 minus 1. So it is your 1. So it is 4 plus 3 by n square. Now this is summation I, means it is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 1 plus n. So its sum is n into n plus 1 by 2. So after solving this, we get 11 by 2 pi plus 3 by 2n. Now we need to get limit when mu p tends to 0. Mu p tends to 0 means n tends to infinity. See what will be the value when mu p tends to 0 or n tends to infinity. Then limit mu p tends to 0 SPF will be 11 by 2, since the 1 by 2 term will go. This is your limit n tends to infinity SPF also. Since the limit exists, therefore the function is integrable. And integration from 1 to 2 fdx will be limit SPF. So this is your 11 by 2. This problem is solved. If you have any query, you can ask me. Similarly, we have one more example. See example 5. Compute integration from minus 1 to plus 1 fdx, where fx is your mod x. See here, with your earlier studied integration techniques, you can solve this problem, but you need to solve this problem by using Riemann integration techniques. See, This function f is bounded and continuous on this closed interval minus 1 to plus 1. Our interval minus 1 to plus 1, so this mod f will be bounded and also continuous. And this fx, it can be written as minus x for x less than or equal to 0 and x for x greater than or equal to 0. Since if you take minus x, it will be positive when x is less than or equal to 0. And if you take x, it will be positive when x is greater than or equal to 0. Let partition P is x0, x1, x2, so on, xn, where x0 is your minus 1 and xn is your 0. And it is after 0, we have 0 equal to y0, y1, y2, so on, yn, and yn equal to 1. So this interval minus 1 to 1 plus 1 is divided into two parts, minus 1 to 0 and 0 into 1, 0 to 1. Divide minus 1, 1 into 2 n equal sub intervals, each of length 1 by n. How? Because this 1 minus minus 1 means 2 by n by 2n. So 2 by 2n is 1 by n. So the length of each sub interval will be 1 by n. So that mu p is equal to 1 by n. It tends to 0 as n tends to infinity. Now your xi, what will be your xi? See here, x0 is minus 1. So x1 is minus 1 per less 1 by n. X2 is minus 1 plus 2 by n, and so on. Xi is minus 1 plus I by n. I is varying from 1 to n. Similarly, yi, y0 is 0, y1 is 0 plus 1 by n, y2 is 0 plus 2 by n, and so on. Therefore, yi is I by n. I is equal to 1 to so on n. Delta xi is your 1 by n, and this is, it is the same as delta yi. So, summation I is equal to 1 to n, delta xi will be 0 minus minus 1 means plus 1. And summation I is 1 to 1 delta yi is 1 minus 0 means plus 1. So both of them are equal. Let ti be any element in delta xi and ti dash in delta yi. And let ti is equal to xi and ti dash is equal to yi. I is varying from 1 to n. So SPF will be summation I is equal to 1 to n fti delta xi plus summation I is equal to 1 to n fti dash delta yi. Substitute the values. This is equal to summation over I. This FTI is minus XI. Why? Because this is minus X. FX is mod X. And when X is less than or equal to 0, it is minus X. So it is minus XI delta XI plus summation over I YI delta YI. It will be YI. Why? Because this FX is X for X greater than or equal to 0. This is equal to summation over I. 1 minus I by N delta XI. Substitute the value of XI. The value of XI is minus 1 plus I by N. So minus XI is 1 minus I by N. And plus summation over I, this YI is Y by N delta YI. So this is equal to summation over I is going from 1 to N delta XI. Minus 1 by N square, summation I is equal to 1 to N I. Plus 1 upon N square, summation I is 1 to N I. So these two will cancel each other. It means we have limit mu p tends to 0, SPF will be simply 1 because its value is 1. 0 minus minus 1 means plus 1. So its value is plus 1. So its limit is plus 1. And since the limit exists, the function is integrable. And integration from minus 1 to plus 1 mod x dx is equal to limit SPF. And this is equal to 1. So we have studied two examples based on our earlier studied theorems. And using the techniques of Riemann integration, we have found integration of two functions as examples. If you have any query, you can ask me your questions here. See here, there are some applications, or you can say properties also. See, first one, if functions f, f1, f2, where f is given as f1 plus minus f2, are bounded and integrable on this closed interval AB. See, these three functions are bounded and integrable. And the interval is common AB, and if it is written as f1 plus minus f2, then we have a result given as integration from A to B f dx is equal to integration from A to B f1 dx plus minus integration from A to B f2 dx. See, let epsilon be any positive number and f is equal to f1 plus f2. This is given in the problem. Since f1, f2 both are integrable, therefore there is this delta greater than 0, such that for any partition, every partition P is given as x0, x1, x2, so on, xn with norm mu p less than delta, And for every choice of points ti and delta xi, we have modulus of summation over fi delta xi, fi ti delta xi minus integration from a to b f1 dx less than epsilon by 2. This is f1, summation over I f1 delta xi, f1 ti delta xi minus integration from a to b f1 dx less than epsilon by 2. And some modulus of summation over I f2 ti delta xi minus integration from a to b f2 dx is less than epsilon by 2. Therefore, we have modulus of summation f1 plus f2 ti delta xi minus integration from a to b f1 dx plus integration from a to b f2 dx is less than epsilon. Why? Because this is equal to modulus of this one plus this one. So this is less than epsilon by 2, this is less than epsilon by 2. Add both of them, it is your epsilon. So it implies that integration from a to b f dx is equal to integration from a to b f1 plus f2 dx. And this is nothing but integration from a to b f1 dx plus integration from a to b f2 dx. So this part is proved. Similarly, we can show that f is equal to f1 minus f2 is also integrable, and integration from a to b f dx is equal to integration from a to b f1 dx minus integration from a to b f2 dx. So this you can also solve. This is over for me today. There are some more results which we will discuss in your next class. Till then, you just read them and make your notes. And if you have any query, you just ask me all your queries here. The lecture will be available on my YouTube channel. You can see there and give comments also.